Problem 69. A uniformly charged cylindrical shell with no end caps, it means it's open, with a negligible thickness, with a charge capital Q, with radius R and length H. Determine the electric potential at a point P, which is located on the X of this cylinder and at a distance D from the right side. Here I give you a suggestion. Use the result of example 25 by treating the cylinder as a collection of a ring charges. It's very important, this point. Let me explain the problem. I told you in the example 25.5, we calculated the electric potential for a ring at the point P. Okay, in this example, we had V of a ring equals to K Q of the ring divided by A square plus X square. And I tell you, you know, the ring is a collection the cylinder is a collection of many rings. What I mean? In order to calculate the total electric potential of this cylinder, I have to integrate the electric potential created by a ring along the length of the cylinder. You know, the summation of many ring give us the total ring cylinder. Okay, so we can say here the total electric potential created by the cylinder is calculated by the integration of the electric potential of one ring, okay, along the length of the cylinder, because the shape of the cylinder is a collection of many rings. Okay, it's important to understand this point. The total okay. So in order to calculate, because you know, in general, if you have, for example, a road, to calculate the potential of this road, I have to take a small element from this object. This small element is DL. To calculate the total potential of this road, we have to integrate this small DQ, this small electric potential created by DQ along the length of the road. From this point to this point, we get the total shape of the road. Also, if we have, for example, a ring, to calculate the total the total potential created by this ring, we take a small portion and we integrate this small element along the length of the ring. We get the total electric potential. It's the same in the case of a cylinder. The small element in the case of a cylinder, it's a ring. So we integrate this small element along the length of the cylinder. Okay? So, you know, V of the ring equals to KQ divided by integral A squared by plus X squared. X squared is the distance between the point P. Here we can take the x-axis, x and y. So the position of the cylinder is, of the ring, is at a distance x. Okay. You know, V of the ring, it's a small element of the total V of the cylinder. So this one of the ring, it's a small element. And Q of the ring, it's a small portion of the total Q of the cylinder. You know, here we have a ring with a thickness dx, because we are along x-axis, with a thickness dx. For a length h, from this point to this point, we have a length h. For this h, we have a total charge q. For dx, only this small portion, how much q we have? We have q of the ring, okay? So we can say here q of the ring equals to q dx divided by h. So now we can find the total electric potential created by the cylinder by the integration like this. We get V of the cylinder in this case, equals to K, Q of the ring equals to Q dx divided by H radical A square plus X square. You know, in this case, the only variable in this integral is X. If we move this small element, from this point to this point, so x must be changed from this point to this point. Okay, it's equal to, okay, from this point to this point. I take this, this is the positive direction, okay? So x is between A, you can say A or D, I give you D, I think, between D and D plus H. So the integral must be between this point and this point, between D and D plus H. This point is D. Okay. Okay, we get the integral of the of this one. You have K is constant. We can put Q is constant, H is constant, but in this case, X is not constant. Okay. Inside we have D and D plus H. And inside we have dq, dx divided by radical a square plus x square. In this case, a in this case is r. You know, I talk in the case of a ring, a is the radius of the ring. Here in this case, I take r as the radius of the ring. So we can put here r in the place of a. Okay, I give you as a hint the value of this integral directly. Okay, let me. Okay, the integral of this one is equal, I give you directly its value. Okay, it's this one. And the answer is here. Okay. This is the total electric potential created by a cylindrical shell at the point P.